What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Chuck Finley here. Let's play Shining Force 2, the Ancient Ceiling, Part 64. Here we are in the Prism Flower fight. And we're going to look at the enemy types we have real quick. The Prism Flowers. HP of 62, attack of 20, defense 55, agility of 44. No movement because they're fixed in their positions. The Prism Flowers are like the laser eye from the first game, where they can shoot in the four cardinal directions, either north, east, south, or west, depending on their position. I think it doesn't matter where they're positioned, they can just shoot in that direction. So, like this Prism Flower would shoot all the way along here, and would hit us as soon as we got down to this little bit of grass here, as well as the other ones you can see pointed around. They can shoot everywhere. And they only hurt for 18 damage, and they do hurt both friend and foe, which is good, but that is kind of annoying because you're trying to get some XP from some of these enemies that might kill them, just like Laser Eye would. But there's a lot of them. Take a look at the map real quick before looking at that new enemy. And you see a lot of enemies, and a lot of those are Prism Flowers, and there's a lot of Bow Riders that can both hit you. And it either hits you for a lot of damage, but most single targets you're flying enemies, or you're flying friendly units, which can do a lot of damage to them. Take a look at the Executioner. HP of 64, attack of 92, defense of 46, agility of 45, movement of 6. The Battle Sword, he will drop that at the end of the fight. Sometimes his attacks do cause level 2, so you need to be watch out for that. And once we get to him, we're going to have to kill him very quickly. Take a look at this demon, because I don't believe we have before. You might have to actually did in the previous fight, so you see the Bow Riders, nothing new with them. A lot of prism powers, like I said, especially in this section through here. Middle, along the sides. So this is going to be a fun fight, but it's not going to be quite as difficult as the next fight that we're going to go to. That will be one of the hardest fights up to this point and in the game. And so the only thing we can do right now is just be careful. Just move down slowly. Try to watch out for the Minotaurs and the Bow Riders, but really there's not a whole lot we can do. We're trying to stay out of the range of the Prism Flowers. Prism Flowers do give good XP though, so if you're a little underleveled or if you want to try to run through this fight a couple times, that's not a bad strategy. But the fight by itself is such a difficult fight because of the Prism Flowers, and it's not a really good leveling fight. Not much in this fight. You need to be able to level up a little bit. Karna, she can be side slayed. But the one good thing about the Prism Flowers is, well, I guess this isn't a good thing, this is kind of a bad thing. They're not like the Laser Eye in the fact that they have a countdown sequence and then they fire, which takes several turn cycles. Well, I guess that's not too bad. 30 damage is about what we should be taking. The Prism Flowers will only hurt. They'll only target you, but they'll also hit. They'll also hit enemies that are in their path. And as you can see from some of the lower Prism Flowers, they'll only target you. They do have a range to them. It is a pretty long range, so you're not going to expect too much. You will expect to take some damage as you get closer to them, but for a while you won't have to worry about taking too much damage from them. I was afraid you were going to do that. That's why I almost went ahead and attacked that Minotaur instead of him. You can see the very bottom Prism Flower can very easily attack Jaha, and he's not, thankfully, so. Like I said, they do have a range too, but once you get into their range, that is a problem. And they can attack you immediately. It's not like the countdown sequence where you could probably heal some people with her. She is under level. Let's see, we'll pull her around here. That'll turn the path of Prism Flower. It wouldn't hurt her at all. I said it only does 18 damage, but with the Griffin around, with the Griffin Minotaur and Bow Rider around, that very well could kill her. And we'll take a look at everyone's XP real quick, because we'll play that fun game now. Everybody should be 17. I need to drop that heat axe to somebody. It's gonna be actually, I think it's Karna doesn't. Kazen doesn't. Jester does. Sarah doesn't. Possibly a prism flower being in the range of a prism flower or that bow rider. That's really the only danger. Wow, I guess that was the max. Happy they're not doing a whole lot of damage. You can see they're taking a lot of damage, but they are giving a lot of XP as well, because they are a one-time enemy that will likely never have to fight again. Not too bad. I was kind of looking for a little bit more, but he goes up to 18. He should be able to attack at 2, defense at 2, and agility 1, so that's pretty standard. I forgot about that dragon. That's good. That's good to know. Oh, yep, I thought that was good. I don't know why he was attacking me. Honestly, I probably should try to heal people who could benefit from this more, but it's in a bad spot to try and use it. Have Bowie level up for healed all the way, chest will level up. Jaha will come pretty close to it. Carter will get herself healed, and she'll get too bad, so that's not too bad. Hopefully this will do a whole lot of that. We'll do that for some sort of critical hit or heavy attack. Get the best sword in the game for Bowie, that'll help out quite a bit. I'm honestly surprised she didn't try to go after Bowie. But that is one thing that the AI does change, is they try to do a lot of damage to a lot of different people. I'll have someone else stay up there and get rid of that prism flower. Might have to interact with me, get rid of that prism flower. 18, each get one, attack up one, defense up one. So this is the worst, that's the worst kind of level you can get where every stat just goes up by one. Thank you. through the lowrider. Unless the lowrider quickly dodges. Welcome back. We're going to run through my characters real quick. Chester, level 19, HP of 88, attack of 79, defense of 60, agility 54, XP of 35. Rick, level 20, HP of 89, attack of 81, defense of 81, agility 59. Gerhardt, level 18, HP of 71, attack of 87, defense of 64, agility 51. Sheila, I did have to give her 2 Brave Apples to get her up to level 19. HP of 63, attack 55, attack. Try it again. Level 19, HP of 63, MP of 55, Attack of 78, Defense of 44, Agility 46, Heal level 2, Blast level 3, Muddle level 2, and Boost level 1. She got Blast level 3 at level 18. Karna, level 21, HP of 77, MP of 70, Attack of 87, Defense of 47, Agility of 53, Heal level 3, Blast level 4, Boost level 2, and Aura level 2. She just got that when she leveled up to 20 of 21. Geralt, 18, HP of 71, Attack of 87, Defense of 40, 64, Agility of 51. Sarah, level 20, HP of 74, Attack 62, Attack, MP of 62, Attack 59, Defense of 54, Agility of 56. Heal level 4, she just got that when she leveled, when she got to level 20. Detox level 3, Blast level 4, and Slow level 2. Kazan, level 19, HP of 59, MP of 82, Attack 61, Defense 52, Agility 55, Dao level 2, Apollo level 2, Neptune level 1, nothing new. Mei level 20, HP of 63, Attack of 80, Defense 54, Agility 48. Bowie level 19, HP of 89, MP of 20, Attack of 84, Defense 67, Agility 51, no new spells. Jaha, level 20, HP of 74, Attack of 84, Defense 76, Agility 56. Slade, level 20, HP of 72, MP of 35, Attack of 83, Defense of 69, Agility 57. Catan, level 2, and Raishin, level 2. He got Raishin, level 2, at level 19. Let me see then. That should be everyone except for Peter. Level 20, HP of 86, Attack of 99, Defense of 71, Agility of 47. And I am a little bit farther than I said I was going to be, and I've had to redo this fight a bunch of times, and I wanted to make sure that I wasn't going to die when I shouldn't have. Yeah, usually about in this area there would be a Mist Demon or a Bow Rider that would kill one of my weaker characters, so I just decided to go ahead and move past those stronger enemies. There is a boat. Actually, I think I got rid of the Bow Rider. There's only these two over here, but those shouldn't pose too much of a threat. I'm not too concerned about either of them. I don't want to kill any. I just want to weaken the Prism Flowers with Mei, because she's already level 20. I probably shouldn't even attack with her, but I would like to keep her up a little bit higher, because once we get past this fight, I think she'll have a little harder time leveling up as easily. I mean, we are thankfully almost done with this fight, so I'm not too concerned about the levels. You know, if some people come out of here, I would like to try to get everyone up to 19, possibly 20. I think going for 21 is just a little bit too optimistic. I don't think I can get anyone up to 21. Or everybody up to 21. You know, of course, there are already people who are 21, but I doubt I'll get everybody up that high. What I've been doing mostly with Rick and Peter is just having them up in the top left corner, level 20, HP of 2, MP of 2, attack up by 1, defense by 1, ability by 2. And that's not too bad. I've had Peter and Rick just stay up in the top left corner, getting rid of those two Prism Flowers, but this fight, both Slade and Chester was able to finish off a Prism Flower each, so that helped them with their leveling. And the worst part, excuse me, worst part about this fight definitely are the Bow Riders and the Mist Demons, but these Prism Flowers are more annoying than anything. They thankfully don't do a whole lot of damage, but they're just, you know, the small amounts of damage that they do will stack up over time, especially if you're in the path of two or more. I think you can only be in the path of two at a time, but, you know, that's 30 damage right there if they all hit you, so definitely want to be very careful. And we'll move Slade up. Like I said, I don't want to move Jaha up as well. I would like to have, like, Bowie kill a Prism Flower. Hopefully he can get to 20. I'd like to have Geralt kill a Prism Flower, get him up a little bit higher. probably have to attack another Prism Flower, but there are plenty of Prism Flowers to attack. Let me see, we will heal Bowie. I don't want him to have, I don't want a Miss Demon or a Bow Rider to hit and kill him. He's already going to be in harm's way, sort of, with the... Apollo, just to make sure. You can actually use Apollo 2 to one-shot a Prism Flower, so if you're dealing with a Prism Flower that is giving you trouble, that is a great way to get rid of them. Probably should have gave that to Gerhult, but I wanted to get rid of that Prism Flower, and also Kaisa needed to level up to 20. Gerhult can do it a lot easier than Kaisa can. The Bow Rider. He is poisoned, so I do need to detox him at some point, but so I wonder if she has detox. No, she does not. So we'll attack the Bow Rider, hopefully killing it in the process. Slade, and that will allow everybody to get some health. Sadly, it is only 18 hit points, but it does a lot of people, so that definitely helps. And she only gets 25 XP from it, but it's better than nothing, definitely. I'll have May, possibly Bowie, come down here and attack this. As I say, if he dies, I'm not gonna be too upset. Probably should have weakened this Prism Flower. We can kill it in his next turn. Let's see, we'll get rid of the Bow Rider since he hasn't had his turn yet. He can attack. Somebody, thankfully he's boxed in and he really can't hit anybody too important. You know, Karna should be able to take some of that. Her defense isn't very high, but she does have a lot of HP, which definitely helps. Flower as well while I'm down there. I took care of the Bow Rider for me. And I wasn't going to get a whole lot of XP from it anyway, so I'm not too upset about that. Rick, he can weaken the Mist Demon. I'll probably have Chester try and actually kill the Mist Demon. That should allow him to level up to 20. If you can actually hit it, of course. I need to heal him pretty quickly here. Now we'll move Slade off. Maybe Gerhult can get in there and deal some damage. Start moving the rest of my force down. Attack by one, defense by two. I'd definitely rather have defense go up with Bowie every time he levels, because we can get stronger swords later on in the game, but that won't really translate into defense. HP of 2, attack by 2, defense by 2, that's not too bad. And we'll heal. We'll just heal Chester. I think I'll have him attack the Mist Demon as well. I was going to pull him closer towards Sarah so that she could detox him, but she's kind of a good ways away anyway. Well, let me see. Yeah, she would be able to reach. And I'll have her attack the Prism Flower. Won't do a whole lot, but that's better than what I expected it to be. Attacking the Prism Flower with Mei. Said I might have Bowie come down there and attack it, I'm not sure yet. And we'll peter down and get him into position. This needs to be healed, a lot of people do actually, but... Chester, Gerhardt does, we'll heal him. This won't do a whole lot, but I guess I keep saying every little bit helps. Probably should give her healing items. I should give every one of my healers healing items as well, so that when they run out of HP or MP, they can still heal. To do that next time, or after this fight. Start putting people in position to move down. Let's see, we'll want to make sure that he's not in the path of that Prism Flower. He's not, so south. I don't want to move people too much farther south than that. 39. 4. We'll go ahead and get rid of the Mist Demon. I would like to go ahead and give it to Gerhardt, but the Mist Demon is just too powerful to leave alive. And like I said, I can have Gerhardt attack a Prism Flower, or you can even have him attack one of those stronger characters or enemy characters down there. Flower, thankfully. 50, that ain't too bad. Alright, let me see, we'll keep them out of the path. We'll be careful because there's a lot of people who are wounded in that. Let's see, what does he have? I think he has Blaze level 4. Yes, he does. He can deal quite a bit of damage to pretty much everybody in my... He could probably kill a lot of these people who are almost dead. And this will give her one more heal level 3 if she needs it. We'll move Gerhardt down. He can just keep attacking the Prism Flower. Probably should move her closer towards the fight, but keep him there for now. Jaha needs it more because I'm worried about that. Chaos Wizard down there, I think is what his name is. I'm worried about him using Blaze level 4. Forgot about that Prism Flower. I thought I was out of the path of every one of them, but that's not too bad. He's got enough defense that if anyone did come up, they wouldn't do a whole lot of damage to him. And we'll move him closer towards Sarah so that she can go ahead and detox him. And we'll just start attacking this shaman. Hopefully we can kill him pretty quickly so that he won't have a chance to level up. Attack by 2, attack by 1, defense by 3. That's not too bad. That's not bad at all. That's probably the most preferable thing. Maybe not. Still did quite a bit of damage to him. We'll use Neptune. The Chaos Wizard being a fire user, this should hurt him for quite a bit, I hope, but might also... It was a respectable amount of damage, but not as much as I would have liked, necessarily. We'll go ahead and get rid of him. He's another one of those enemies that are just too powerful to leave alive, and Blaze level 4 only costs 10 MP, and he can use it 4 times, and then he can use the lesser. The lesser blazes more times than that, so there's no reason to leave him alive. Probably won't have Kate. Well, it really just depends on if Kazan can move down quick enough. If he can't, I won't have him attack it with anything anyway. May should be able to take care of it in her next turn, so... Fine, Peter can knock out the shaman, so that takes away the healing ability. Not gonna do a whole lot of, or not gonna give out a whole lot of XP, but kind of expected that. And Peter quickly dodges, so that's good. If I can get Chester and Gerhalt down. So we'll just move May there, and we'll attack the Prism Flower, get rid of that. Would have liked to have given that to Gerhalt, but like I said, both him and Chester can easily get back what they don't get XP-wise. Hate to attack the Executioner. But I hate to leave him as well. I'll weaken it enough so that either... Ooh, wow. So that Gerhalt or... Someone can... Gerhalt or Chester can take care of it. We'll heal somebody just for the XP, or probably have her heal herself. So just for the XP, hopefully she can... hopefully she can level up to... Maybe I can hold out for a full turn of cycle and have both Peter and Geralt, or Chester and Geralt attack it. He can keep attacking Peter. I don't mind at all. Peter will definitely kill it. That's better than him, than the Prism Flower attacking two targets at once. No, she'll die if I stick her. I was gonna have her heal Peter, but I'll just have her heal Chester instead. So she could hit level 20, she could hit 21. And I will just have her weaken it. Like I said, she can't do a whole lot of damage to it anyway, and this will... her being there actually takes away a spot. Geralt. Crap. He's 20, so... that's good. Everything went up by one except for defense, which went up by two. This is defense at four. Well, we'll go ahead and end it. And I have to wait two turn cycles now because of Sarah being in the way. And dropped a battle sword, so that is something that if you don't have an open slot, you won't be able to grab the battle sword, so you do need to watch out for that. And so now that we've finally done with that fight, I thank you for watching. Next time we're gonna go into another battle immediately, so we gotta look forward to that. That one will be harder than the Prism Flower fight, if you can actually believe that. So until then.